Good day to you, summoners, and welcome back to another Wild Rift video. My name is Nathan Ng, and today we'll be looking into Wild Rift's jungle pathing for patch 2.1. This video offers insight for everyone. It is always helpful to know what is happening inside the fog of war and what you can do about your jungle gap. Alright, let's go ahead and just jump right into it. There's a saying that junglers are the babysitters of the team, and indeed, they are. They are in charge of getting their laners ahead and capitalizing on the lead by doing objectives. Another key thing to remember is that junglers are calling the shots throughout the game. Coupled with their decisions of what objectives to take and what lane to gank, they must exert insane pressure on the enemy. However, pulling off that oppressive playstyle doesn't come easy. Having said that, don't sweat it. We've got the only guide that you'll need to do to put that kind of pressure. First off comes the early clear in Wild Rift. It is very important that we have a plan on what to do early on. Our camps start spawning at 20 seconds in the game, which leaves us without much time to think about the strategic aspects of the game in the heat of the moment. What side to start on and how to sequence camps represent why jungle is a very thought-heavy role. To make it easier to understand, let's just go ahead and take a look at an easy and impactful early clear. In most challenger games, you'll see a stronger jungle get a leash on a buff by his dual lane. Instantly clearing the first buff, they then move on to finish the entirety of the jungle before transitioning into Scuttlecrab. Now you've already hit level 4 before you even start to gravitate towards the other Scuttlecrab. This clear allows us to stay close proximity to our duo and mid lane. Consequently, we are also in a position to easily counter any gank attempt by the enemy jungle. Moving over to the second scuttle and actually getting it on top of clearing our chickens gets us level 5 at roughly 2 minutes and 20 seconds. That's crazy fast, but watch out for the following parts of the video, you can hit 5 even faster. We've all seen it happen. The enemy Lee Sin appears on a lane, safeguards close to your ally, and shortly after you hear the message, an ally has been slain, you might be asking, how you can become like that Lee Sin? Here's how. As a jungler, it's very important to look at what's happening on the lanes. How low is my opponent and where on the lane is he as of right now? Enemy resources and positioning play a huge part in whether they are gankable or not. To figure out if they're gankable, we simply follow a little checklist. Where is the wave and where is it going? This tells us where the enemy is going to be in the near future. The further he steps away from his tower towards ours, the more likely we are able to pull off a successful gank. And that's not all. Them being so far away from the tower enables us to approach them from behind, cutting off their escape. Two birds with one stone. Aside from that, remember to take a good look at your opponent's movement on lane, especially when they're moving towards river brushes. That specific movement indicates potential wards that we can avoid to hide our presence, giving the enemy a false sense of security. I bet most of you can think of a situation where they placed a ward, felt safe, and still died to a gank. It happens to all of us. But let's make sure that we use it to step up our play. Before I go any further, make sure to hit that like and subscribe for everything Wild Rift, and join our Wild Rift Discord in the description down below. Make no mistake about it, ganking enemies and killing them feels great, but it doesn't always work. So, what if we don't spot opportunities to gank? Having a backup plan is immensely helpful. Let me give you a better idea of how that backup plan might start to look like. We've locked in the Monkey King, Wukong. Level 1, we're skilling Nimbus Strike, giving us 35% attack speed for 4 seconds upon casting it. At the start, we're receiving a dual lane leash on our Krugs and Smite the Big Krug. Smite's low cooldown will be up again by our next camp, the Red Buff. Our abilities Warrior Trickster in combination with Nimbus Strike helps us quickly take care of Red Buff. Chickens come next, and we are ready to fight around the scuttle at 125 when it spawns. This is very similar to the default clear presented earlier with slightly different sequencing. But here's the deal. If we cannot find gank opportunities, we should not brute force ganks where they have a low chance of working out. It's way more beneficial to transition towards the other Scuttlecrab and clear out our other jungle side. Camps respawn every 90 seconds and buffs every 150 seconds. Cycling them efficiently is also a viable way to stay relevant. Yet, there is something I've learned over years of experience. Plans are just plans and might be adjusted every few seconds thanks to the new information. The point is that regardless of your plans, you need to be aware of what your available options are. Be ready to adjust at any given moment. This will most definitely make you climb. We're going to be quickly summarizing some common routes and their XP values. Clearing any side of your jungle puts you at level 3, slaying scuttle grants us level 4, killing another scuttle as well as a camp accelerates us to 5. Alright, it's time for our question of the day. What jungle champion do you fear facing the most? Lee Sin takes the cake for me. His ability to just close out the gap and start pummeling me is still haunting my dreams. Let us know your comments down below. Imagine just peacefully clearing your blue buff and the enemy Olaf flashes over the wall who's gonna chase you down, throwing undertow after undertow at you. Scary, right? I'll show you how to either avoid this or become the Olaf himself. So listen, The moment the game starts, you have to instantly walk towards the positions that you expect ganks from and place down your ward. You have very limited time to do so as your first camp spawns in 20 seconds. You can suggest your laner to place a ward over the wall at blue buff, showing you Gromp and blue buff. And you make sure that you ward the other side of the map that you expect the enemy to make a move from. Having both sides warded offers you information about their start and their potential goals. Let me show you exactly how you can make use of that information. Picture this. You're in Olaf and you start with blue buff, skipping Gromp and going straight into wolves. Red buff is next and chickens follow after. Now, you're level 4 and you see that the enemy hasn't killed his blue buff yet, and this opens up an entirely new option, invading. We know that we can take the enemy jungle in a 1v1 as we are Olaf, and we can quickly run towards their blue buff and fight them at it. Remember, us hitting level 5 at 220, you won't believe me, but you'll be stunned. Hitting level 5 at 151 is possible if you happen to kill the enemy jungler at that blue buff. And trust me, Olaf usually kills his enemies thanks to his tremendous 1v1 power. So even if you face champions like a Shyvana who are known to be potential powerhouses, don't fear them, axe them. Following on that aggressive note, when you get things taken from you, it generally feels pretty bad. Getting camps taken away from us in Wild Rift doesn't only feel bad, it also drains money from us. Putting this into perspective, enemy camps should always be taken away if you're given the opportunity to do so. Draining their resources while bolstering yours is a powerful and essential aspect of being efficient at the jungle. For this, you can follow a simple rule of thumb. Given the option to do so, enemy camps should always be taken, making them a priority. Neutral camps such as a scuttle follow shortly after, and allied camps come last as we can return to our jungle and farm them safely anyway. Realizing when to take enemy camps is generally linked to other junglers' presence. Where is he right now and what is he doing? Our job is to do something that hurts them while they're going to be doing something that hurts our team. We do not want them to get away for free. Realizing these little bits of information and acting upon them doesn't only make us look fantastic, but we're also going to get closer to the elo that we desire. You might wonder how junglers stay relevant throughout the game. What is the difference between a high elo jungler and you? And more importantly, how can you become like him? Let me paint you a picture here. Putting emphasis on the previous points, spamming ganks doesn't always work. We're in need of alternatives and information to get access to those options. So, what does this all mean for you? In essence, we want to establish our lead by playing around our spikes and our laners. We're going to want to shadow our laners as they appear to be overextending. Shadowing refers to being unseen by the enemy yet being in close by. This gives us the option to counter the gank and absolutely crush the enemy further, snowballing our lead. As a result, we might deny the enemy team of a few waves on top of sealing their jungle camps. More importantly than that is that we're even going to get free objectives as well. They are quite powerful and change the pace of the tempo of the game upon securing them, be it destroying a tower with the power of Herald or sieging the enemy base with an empowered Baron minion. Can you really afford not to use a strategy like that? The next tier is waiting for you, so go get there. Aside from that, one thing's certain. Items are equally as useful as those strategies. If you want to see what the highest level of players in Wild Rift build to stomp their opponents, make sure you check out our other video, 6 OP item combos and 6 OP items. We're hyped to offer you all the tools that you need to gain more elo and control over your game. Last but not least are the champion recommendations with a few pointers as to how to pilot these. We will start with Lee Sin, a strong and mobile bruiser. His strength is fast movement, allowing him to close nearly any gap between him and the enemy. A default clear for him should look like this. Starting at red buff with the leash, using his sonic wave to get over the raptor camp and clear it. Afterwards, hopping the wall over to the mid lane, transitioning to the other side of the jungle. This opens up the possibility to react to an early gank opportunity, as well as denying an enemy gank. Next comes Olaf. Olaf is known for his strong 1v1 fighting prowess. Losing 1v1? Not with Olaf. Throwing his axe and picking it up allows him to chase down enemies with ease. To quickly recap what we've shown earlier, you can either fully clear a jungle site and transition into two scuttlecrabs back to your own jungle, or going into the more aggressive route with invading. Both options are perfectly viable given the right circumstances. Putting more emphasis on objectives, Shyvana will be your dragon to tame. Shyvana's strength is primarily centered around getting dragons. Each dragon grants her dragon form a different buff and makes her a menace on the rift. Is it considered cannibalism if she's only half dragon? I don't know. Compared to the other champions, she lacks a gap closing ability before level 5, as she can only run after you. This makes her relatively weak in contesting the scuttle. It is better for you to give up the contested scuttle and focus on the uncontested one synced up with the full clear. In light of her dragon-centric playstyle, make sure that you're there every 4 minutes. Wukong is wrapping up our champion recommendation. Compared to the other characters, he might seem like an odd suggestion. He is decently strong in a 1v1, but his ganks seem lacking in comparison. Yet he offers true power in teamfighting situations with his ultimate ability, Cyclone. More than that, he can turn invisible for 1 second, creating confusion inside of the teamfight, leaving the enemy guessing where he actually is. Thinking back to our other video about 14 tips that will make you better on any position, you can already guess what that is doing to your enemy. That is going to be concluding our jungle pathing for 2.1. Please hit that like and subscribe if you want to receive all that you need to know about anything in the Wild Rift. We also got a great and welcoming community with the Discord. If you want to be part of that Discord, check out the link in the description down below. I'm eager to see what you guys replied to for our question of the day. And as always, my name is Nathan Ng. Stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful day. Peace.